there's, never mind. That sentence was going to be, there's a pigeon up there. Let's see if we can get a photo of the pigeon against that nice soft sky. Then the pigeon left. So I guess the answer is no.
Today, I'm just going for a nice relaxing evening stroll to take some photos in this lovely soft light, hopefully of some lovely soft things. So go grab a cup of tea, have a sit down, and let's just go for a nice chill walk together, shall we?
Our camera and lens combo for this super chill adventure is going to be the Fujifilm X-T4 with the Fujifilm 50-140mm f2.8. Now, I know it doesn't look like the calmest, chillest combination of things, but trust me, he's a sweetheart. This is brilliant for taking photos of all sorts of things, like this leaf, or a squirrel, or a pigeon. You know, the three pinnacles of calmness. Or if that doesn't tickle your fancy, why not guy riding scooter in London next to hilarious license plate? On the embankment here, there is a little sort of boat rental thing, and the blue boats in the background might look really cool all bokered out if we can get a photograph of this swan. Now, I also need the swan to face this way a little bit, which would be good of it. Excuse me, swan. Hello, senor. It is not a Spanish swan. Bonjour. Oh, it might be French. Well, it looks like it's got a broken neck, but I think I got my photo of the swan. Welcome to Swan Beach. Population, 9 swans, a goose, and, oh, 0 pigeons. Never mind, just 9 swans and a goose. Swans always look so graceful when you watch them from a distance, but then you get kind of close and you can see this sort of stuff happening. And like, whatever washboard over here is doing. I don't know what tunes he's listening to, but I'm all for them. All right, calm down. These lovely, colourful flowers set against this kind of dingy, falling apart, graffitied brick wall is kind of a cool combination, actually. I really kind of like it. It's got that kind of, I don't want to say post-apocalypse vibe, because, you know, you don't really want to describe a city as looking like it's been through an apocalypse, but you know what I mean. I love external framing, right? So you've got these bars here, the next set of bars through there, and then sat on top of the fence, the other side, is a pigeon. Just chilling in his little frame, having a grand old time. Maybe it's her frame. I don't know how to tell with pigeons. And when I try to get close enough to ask, they fly away, which is unhelpful. And it's not a calm photo. Do you mind, Mr. Train? I'm trying to do calm here. Thank you. And it's not a calm, chill photo walk unless you're taking photos of flowers. So here's a photo of some flowers, because flowers are pretty. I really think almost everybody's first proper photo is of a flower. It's like the first thing you do when you get a camera, you take it outside, you find a flower, you take a photo of the flower, because flowers are pretty. Yes. Just trying to get a shot of this public footpath sign with as much of this greenery in the foreground as possible, because it looks like it's an old sign in the middle of like an overgrown wood type area. The fact that it's covered in what look like cobwebs really, really adds to the effect too. I hope that if nothing else, this is giving you an idea of the types of photos that this 50-140mm lens can take. Like, this path leading off into the distance at 140mm is really coolly compressed. Is coolly a word? Because it feels like it isn't. Like coolly. No, saying it more times doesn't help. I've just spotted two people that are having a much chiller time than I am. I'm gonna try and not fall in the river while I look, but these two here that are just floating down the river having a great time, that looks perfect, doesn't it? Doesn't that look awesome? I want to do that. Possibly not with this, it doesn't look very waterproof. Also, I don't like swimming or being wet in general. I've talked myself out of it. I'm gonna take a little step towards the river here just to stop and just appreciate all of this noise. Oh, I love that noise. That's amazing. What is that? What kind of Pokemon is this? There are lots of these plants right the way down the river. I don't know what the plants are called, but I like them. And I want this shot, right? So you've got the plant on the right side of the frame, you've got the river leading off down into the distance, and this is the most basic shot you could probably get in this location. But it's so calm though. It's so calm though. Isn't it zen? I don't really have a set end location for this walk. So far it's just been follow whatever path I happen to be on and occasionally stop and point at things and go, ooh, that's whatever it is. And I'll be honest, that's pretty grand. That's pretty good. I enjoyed that. You should try it. Just pick a direction and go. Probably not like directly towards the ocean because then you'll drown. And that's not calm. That is a stressful time for you. Maybe like avoid roads as well, because that's where cars are and they hurt. So basically what I'm saying is don't just pick a direction and wander, but do. I have to say, picking a direction and going for a wander is starting to let me down too, because I'm wearing shorts and a lot of this is stinging nettles. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Jack, if the path is getting worse, why don't you just turn around and go back the way you came? And that is because I'm dumb and I'm not going to do that, because that would be a smart person thing to do. Look at this cutie. There's a little swan just having a grand old time swimming along the river. Get that nice reflection shot and also get all of this bokeh out greenery in the foreground. I love it. I love a swan portrait. You can't take a bad photo of a swan, except the one I took earlier. But apart from that one, it can't be done. Apart from this other time that I managed to do it. But other than those two times that I took a bad photo of a swan, you can't do it. Ah yes, and now begins my walk through the leaf tunnel. I genuinely am unsure as to where I am. Spoilers though, if you're watching this video, it means I survived. Aha, it looks like there is a bridge here. I'm not sure what that solves, but you know, something different. Oh. hang on. Ugh. Well, it looks like there was a bridge here. And now there is not. Oh, neat. This looks like a big giant dandelion puff. I was going to try quite hard to make sure this video wasn't just me taking photos of flowers, but I mean, I've given up. So on the plus side, I have worked out where I am. I have now wandered over to Peterborough's rowing lake, which does mean that this path, like almost every other path in England, leads directly to a pub. Specifically, it leads to this pub, which actually does look quite cute poking out of the trees there, especially with the reflection. Reflections are very calm. I don't know if it counts as another flower picture, but look at these weeds growing out of this stick. This, whatever these are called. It's one of these, but there's half of it, and there's stuff growing out of it. This feels like a very calm place to finish today's very calm video. And you know what? We need to get one more photo, so we're going to get a nice, calm photo of a nice, calm duck. This little soft one that's just sat down in front of us, I think. Yeah, with all the other animals behind it, all bokeh'd out, looking nice and calm. This is a soft duck. It flopped down on the floor. Very cute. But that's it. So, the video is now over. It is time to stop looking at geese, although they are all very, very cute. And it is time to go home. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this camera. I certainly did. So, goodbye. I can't wave. I've run out of hands. Goodbye. Thank you again for watching. I'm kind of whispering because I'm worried I'll wake the ducks up if I don't. Although there are people over there playing with a football who do not care for the duck's sleep schedule, which is probably a far more sane state of mind. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel and press the like button to signify your liking of the video. That is all the instruction I have for you. Goodbye and good night. Mwah.